I've put you in 9-2, Mr. Headingley, sir, your old rooms.
Mr. Burkett. Well, well, well.
This way, Mr. Headingley, sir, if you please. Mustn't hold me up, you know. Say one thing, the college rowing's never been the same since you went down.
I'm not completely forgotten, then, Mr.
Not Burkett. Forgotten by any means, Mr. Headingley, sir. Climbing in and out at all hours.
Oh, surely not.
Ladies in till breakfast time more than once. Darrell, coming tonight. Mr. Sims, Mr. Buckle, Mr. Rogers, they're all coming. And we've certainly picked the right day for it.
We certainly have, Mr. Burkett.
We certainly have.
They always say the same thing when they come back. The old place doesn't change very much, Mr. Burkett, does it, they say. We've the new lock down by the river, of course. We've had one or two sit-ins. They've painted King Henry red a few times, but that's one thing you could say about the gentlemen of your generation. They would never dream of defacing the college, not when they were sober. That's the difference, you see. Sherry at 7:30, Mr. Headingley, sir. And dinner at 8. And you haven't forgotten the step, have you, Mr. Headingley, sir?
I haven't forgotten anything, Mr. Burkett. I feel as if I'd never been away.
Is Mr. Headingley here, Mr. Burkett?
He's in his old rooms, Mr. Buckle, sir.
We're all in our old rooms, are we, Mr. Burkett?
You are, Mr. Buckle, sir.
David Buckle!
Christopher Headingley.
Good heavens!
My word!
Well, well, well!
Great Scott!
Good God!
How very odd to see you again like this, Christopher.
How very odd to see you!
Goodness me!
Well, come in, come in!
Step! Oh!
Yes!
Well!
How are you and so on?
Well, all right, Christopher. Not too bad. In quite good working order. And you?
Oh, fine. Fine, 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 fine.
Good.
And you're sawing people up, eh?
What? Out with their waterworks?
My word.
And you're parliamentary undersecretary, is that what they call it? At the Department of... Isn't it, in fact, education?
Off with their heads.
Goodness me.
Tell the Vice Chancellor when he gets off.
Well, well, well.
It's funny, you know. You haven't changed at all.
Nor have you. Isn't it odd?
It's curious. You don't expect people to have changed, but when you meet them and they haven't, you're somehow surprised.
Isn't it odd?
Doesn't change much, does it, Mr. Crineside?
Doesn't change at all, Mr. Burkett.
They all say exactly the same when they come back.
Still looks as much like Wormwood Scrubs as ever.
That's the way, Mr. Crine, sir. I said to the master, as soon as I saw your name on the list, I said, that one will be making a crack or two about us before the weekend's out. You're not forgotten, you see, Mr. Crine.
Dead, but not forgotten.
Now, come along, Mr. Quine. I've put you in 9-4. Your old rooms, Mr. Quine, sir.
My old rooms? Haven't they made a start on slum clearance in this town yet?
Well, we've a beautiful day for it. Not even you can deny that, Mr. Quine, sir.
The sad thing about having a beautiful day for something, Mr. Burkett, is that it would be just as beautiful for something else.
I mean, we all have changed.
Oh, I should think there's rather more of us.
More of us?
In some ways,
yeah. Yes. Though, of course, in other ways, rather less of us.
Oh, you mean poor old Ted?
Poor old Jimmy.
Jimmy?
Jimmy McBride.
I didn't know that.
Heart.
No.
Yes. And drink.
And, of course, it's poor old Arthur.
Yes. It's poor old Arthur.
Talk of my life.
Never have imagined.
Oh, I never drunk.
What was it in the end?
5 years.
5 years.
Peter.
Hello, puppy. I haven't seen you for years.
Funny. I haven't thought about that bathhouse since I went down.
But as soon as you saw it...
As soon as I saw it, I just kind of went on from where I left off.
You think you remember everything.
Then when you look, you realize there's a whole lot of things you've forgotten.
Funny thing, memory, isn't it?
Oh, dear.
What?
Alan Quine. Oh. Hello, Alan. Remember me?
Yes.
David Buckle.
Yes.
Hello, Alan.
Minister?
Oh, bores. None of that nonsense here.
How are you these days, Alan?
Broke.
Aren't we all?
Are we?
You married, Alan?
Occasionally.
I see.
Children?
On Sundays.
Well, we'll see you later then.
Expect you will.
I'd forgotten Klein, I must admit.
I hadn't. He's in my department. He's one of my civil servants.
Oh, dear. In the Department of Education, in charge of educating people.
Don't know what he does. Puts the splinters in schoolroom benches, I expect.
Oh, I dare say he's grown up a bit since we knew him.
He was very immature.
I always thought he might have been all right if one could have got him on his own.
Yeah, he was in a rather nasty set.
What was that appalling little man called?
Oh, that ghastly camp little man.
Alan! Yoo-hoo! Alan!
Dickie Sainsbury.
You're both looking radiant.
Hello, Dickie. We're just talking about you.
Isn't it all wonderful being back? All those embarrassingly familiar faces. Like the old shoes at the bottom of the wardrobe. Isn't it all absolutely frightful?
It is rather curious.
We were just saying.
Well, what a funny thing memory is.
That kind of thing.
Alan, is he there?
He's in the bathhouse.
Someone told me you were the Prime Minister.
Not quite, I'm afraid.
It must have been someone else.
I suppose he might have changed.
Hardly looks like it.
You mean the fancy dress?
We're supposed to be shocked, are we?
Well, I expect when he sees we're not, he'll go and take it off.
Yeah, probably. Take everything off.
You're thinking of that show that he and Quine got up.
Yeah, the day the Queen Mother came.
And Sainsbury came prancing on in nothing but false eyelashes and a coat of gold paint.
Yeah. And we all find ourselves on page one of the People next Sunday.
Alan? 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 Come on, I know you're in there. Look, are you bathing or drowning yourself? Oh, dear. This is going to be even worse than I expected. Come on, Alan, you could manage a couple of words, couldn't you? I mean, what's the news? How many wives have you got, eh? Alan!
God almighty.
No, Dickie Sainsbury, but it's a flattering mistake.
What is that thing round your neck?
You know, I thought no one was ever going to ask. You don't think it makes me look old, do you?
Makes you look like a clergyman.
Only I keep seeing myself in shop windows as I go by and thinking I just look like someone dressed up as a clergyman.
You are someone dressed up as a clergyman.
Yes, but underneath I am, in fact, a clergyman.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am, Alan. It's on my passport.
You read geography.
I was a late vocation. Honestly, Alan, I baptize babies. I solemnize weddings. I church women.
Come in. Norman Tate.
Hello, Chris.
I'm just popping round to see everybody.
Oh. Norman Tate, good heavens.
Good heavens, David Buckle. Well, well. I don't need to ask what you two are getting up to these days, because you're both frightfully famous, but I bet you don't know what I do.
Oh, go on.
I'm a writer.
I didn't know you had literary leanings.
No. I just suddenly blossomed out. Children's novels, light verse, stories of famous operas.
I can see we're going to have to watch our step tonight, Chris.
We'll be right back in the People and the News of the World again.
No, but seriously, if you ever want a professional hand with your memoirs, pop it behind the clock, just in case. Anyway, I must be slipping along. I want to pop my head in on Roddy Moore.
Roddy Moore?
Is Roddy Moore coming?
I looked at the list. He's got his old rooms upstairs.
Oh, well, if old Roddy's coming, that's different.
Oh, Roddy will make the party go, eh?
Let's go up and give him a surprise.
It's not like Roddy to come to a thing like this.
No, but how like Roddy to do something that's not like him? Would you believe it? The lovely Auntie Norman. Hello, Dickie.
Hello, Alan.
You look younger than ever.
Oh, I don't know about that.
No. You don't look a day over 50.
Good heavens, I'm 44.
Well, when you were 20, it was 55. You didn't look a day over. Dickie, what's this thing round my neck? This thing round my neck, Norman, dear, is a junk clergyman's kit. I bought it in Woolworths this afternoon. Cost 45p and it's washable.
Well, you two haven't changed, I can see that.
Now, don't go on, Norman. Don't get started. Just say something profound before you go. Nothing long, just deep. Short and deep, strange and sad and curiously consoling. The rich distillate of half a lifetime. Record your message now.
Oh, well, I was just going to say that Roddy Moore's coming.
Roddy Moore? Alan, did you hear that? Well done, Norman. That was short and deep and very strange.
Roddy wouldn't come to a thing like this, would he?
I looked at the list.
All right, let's go and mock him.
It's rather improbable when you come to think about it. I mean, he was last seen with his head shaven entering a monastery in Sikkim.
I heard he was doing a milk round in Kentish Town.
He's down on the list.
Shh.
No?
Late as ever.
Trust old Roddy.
I think the last time I heard of him, he was working with a construction gang in Anatolia.
Now, someone told me they'd seen him selling Union Jack knickers on 42nd Street.
Or is that him now?
Roddy!
Is everything under control?
Perfectly, Your Ladyship.
The sherry's holding out?
Effortlessly.
Now, you have chilled the hock and warmed the claret and opened the sauterne and decanted the port and fetched up the brandy and put the whiskey in the old library for afterwards and broached the beer for when the whiskey runs out. I don't want them to miss anything just because Harry's away.
Even if the master were here, I think there's little more he could offer them without considerable risk of alcoholic poisoning, Your Ladyship.
And your overtime ban begins at midnight.
Well, I shall ensure they've drunk their way through the complete list before the industrial action commences, Your Ladyship.
You are making certain that the general public are kept out. I don't want anyone to get the wrong impression.
No, out there being absolutely kept, Your Ladyship.
Excuse me, I tried my lodgings, but they've been made into a maternity home.
I do apologize, Your Ladyship.
They said they couldn't do anything for me.
Have you tried the local youth hostel?
The old boy
went this set. What, Dr. Bullard?
Says Dr. W.R. Taylor now.
Old Bullard only died a couple of years ago, you know. It is an awfully nice obit for him in the Times.
I think you will find them all foregathering in the Fellows' Garden, Mr. Sainsbury and Mr. Tate, sir.
You were never young, were you, Mr. Birkett?
Well, certainly not, Mr. Sainsbury, sir. I was far too busy.
Sydney!
Dr. Taylor, sir.
You won't forget that the Joint Action Committee is banned all overtime working as of midnight tonight.
I won't forget, Dr. Taylor, sir, and you won't forget that you're down to say grace.
These are our kids, aren't they?
They came up 20 years ago.
Now they're back in for servicing and banker's order form.
New building has to be paid for somehow.
They're not bad, are they, Sydney? Were they convincing as undergraduates?
Not particularly.
I sometimes look at our present generation of undergraduates and wonder if we're still turning out a credible oppressor class.
Oh, I think that with time, Dr. Taylor, sir, with a little bottle age, they'll turn out to be something like the very drinkable vintage we have here tonight.
Rosemary!
Oh. Oh, hello, Christopher.
Well, 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 this is a surprise.
Yes, what a surprise.
Goodness me.
Quite a shock.
I keep meeting Harry, of course, at committees and conferences, but we haven't met for what?
17 years.
No.
When Harry and I got married.
Well, how nice of you to pop round and say hello.
Oh, well...
Oh, you weren't?
Oh, yes. Yes, of course I was.
Some other lucky fella.
No. I just wanted to say one thing. I know Harry would have liked to ask you round to the lodge for a quiet drink at some time.
Oh, how nice. What time?
But sadly, he's away this weekend.
Oh, Harry's away, is he?
He's in Montreal. Well, I must dash off. With Harry away, I've been left to sprint round and organize everything.
You're not still riding your bicycle, are you, Rosemary?
Oh, this old thing.
Oh, many's the time I saw you wheeling that bicycle into college, on your way to have tea with some lucky man.
Yes, I've had quite a lot of use out of it.
Rosemary, why don't we... have a drink and a bit of a chat later on, anyway.
Well, I'd have liked
to. I can see old Harry any time. Come round here after dinner.
Christopher, I've changed a lot since you knew me.
Oh, good heavens, Rosemary, I didn't mean that.
No, I didn't mean that.
No, I mean, I've changed.
Yes, I didn't mean you meant that.
No, I meant to have a chat about... old times.
Yes. No. What I had in mind was that it might not be quite the thing for the master's wife to be flittering about people's rooms in the middle of the night.
No, of course not.
Given the circumstances.
Oh, yeah, you mean because of Roddy?
What do you mean because of Roddy?
Well, I mean, you have this great thing with Roddy.
I can't see what this has got to do with Roddy.
And then you suddenly married Harry.
But why do you keep talking about Roddy?
Oh dear, have I put my foot in it?
Look, I haven't seen Roddy for 17 years. I don't suppose I shall ever see him again.
I'm awfully sorry, Rosemary. I seem to have said all the wrong things.
You always did. I can't think how you ever became a politician.
Anyway, let me put it like this. If you happen to be passing this way after dinner...
I shan't be.
You know where I am.
I know where you are.
Well, let's leave it like that.
Let's leave it like that.
Well, it's always nice seeing you again, Rosemary.
I must dash along and chase things up.
I've always admired you from a distance, you know.
Yes, I remember.
Well, I must rush along and drink some sherry.
That's right, Christopher. You rush along and drink some sherry. nice to see you again.
Rosemary Gilbert.
Well, Rosemary Driver now, of course.
Oh, yes, of course, you married that Don with a loud laugh, for you used to come to Dickie's parties.
Harry Driver.
Sir Harry Driver.
Yes, he now is.
So you're, the Lady Driver.
I didn't know he was going to get knighted when I married him.
And now he's Master of the College, which makes you what? The College Mistress?
I see you haven't changed much, Alan.
Well, come in, Rosemary. Come in.
Oh, well...
It was me you were calling on, was it?
I was just going to look in for a moment.
On your way to see Roddy, were you?
Why should I want to see Roddy?
Oh, I don't know. Tell him it was all a terrible mistake and it was him you should have married after all, or...
You can't still be bitter.
Oh, I'm not bitter. Sentimental, if anything. You know, I often think of the last time I saw you. You were wearing a long white dress.
Oh, that white taffeta ball gown.
It was a warm summer's evening. The moon was shining. I looked out of my bedroom window at the back here, and there you were, dangling on the wall with your dress caught in the spikes.
Oh, then.
You were climbing in to see Roddy.
It finished the dress off. I suppose it served me right. I'd just been to some terrible kind of ball with someone else and run out on them halfway through.
Yes, me.
No.
Yes.
Oh, God. I suppose I behaved badly to everyone that year.
Yes.
It was my last year. I wanted to somehow get hold of it all before it disappeared.
You got hold of half the college.
There were 10 men to every woman at the university in those days. You have to remember that.
You fought gallantly against hopeless odds.
That's what it felt like sometimes. You don't realize.
Come up and have a drink after dinner.
Oh, I can't, I'm afraid.
Busy?
Well, Harry's away.
We'll manage without Harry.
Alan, I'm an entirely different sort of person now.
Oh.
I sit on committees. I'm on the bench.
Not in the middle of the night, surely.
I must go.
Don't you want to see if Roddy's arrived yet?
Well, 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 fancy our forgetting you, Mr. Snell, sir.
Oh, I don't suppose anyone remembers me.
I never forget a name, I never forget a face. But, we've left you off the list, you see.
I'm sorry. I sent in the form. I'm sorry.
Never mind, Mr. Snell, sir. We'll fit you in. This way, Mr. Snell, sir.
I never had rooms in college. I should have had them in my third year, but I got left off the list. I was out in lodgings all the time, out beyond the station. I don't suppose anyone even realised I was a member of the college.
Oh, well, here we are, Mr. Snell, sir. I think you'll be happy in here.
But these are Roddy Moore's rooms.
Oh, Mr. Moore can't be with us tonight, sir. We had a message this afternoon. There's the bell for hall, Mr. Snell, sir. You've just time to change.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Burkett. It's very kind of you to fit me in. Me off the list. Huh. Won't muck about with me, old lad. People who muck about with me find themselves in big trouble.
You called, Mr. Snell, sir?
Called? No, I didn't call.
I beg your pardon, Mr. Snell, sir.
Talking to myself. That's the accusation now, is it? Doesn't bloody scare me.
Rosamund.
Oh. Oh, William.
I know what you're after, Rosamund. The answer's no.
No?
I can't ask you in. I'm due to say grace. I'll walk across the hall with you. No, no, no. Well, you've come to seduce me, haven't you?
I beg your pardon?
Now, come on, Harry, something.
Harry, Mary sent me to seduce you.
Away from the Joint Action Committee to stop the industrial action.
Oh, the industrial action.
Well, it won't work, Rosemary. Life's not like that.
Look, Harry's not even here.
Oh, Harry's not here.
He's in Montreal.
All right, come round for a drink after dinner and we'll really get down to it. But I warn you, Rosemary, I'll have you on the floor. Cibo, nos tibi pater, gratias agibus, obsecrantes ut sibum, angelorum, Jesum Christum, Dominum nostrum, nobis, impetiare, ut eo mens nostra pescato, et corroboramur. Amen.
Amen. Oh, well.
They were very generous with the drink, I must say.
Ah, they did us awfully well.
Awfully well.
Oh, awfully well.
Awfully good speech, Chris.
Oh, does it seem all right? Oh, just the top.
Well, where is he then?
Where's who?
Roddy, where's Roddy?
Yes, come on. Let's find Roddy.
Come on.
Wait till you see him. Will he be able to get up the stairs?
Oi. We're looking for Roddy Moore.
Yes, so are we.
Well, more than many. Rob the shark. Where are you, Roddy?
A rucksack on its rust. Oh, Roddy. Cycle clip.
Cycle here, all the way from Sikkim.
Alaska. I thought it was Turkey.
I think it's Sikkim.
I think it's Alaska.
I think I'm slightly pissed.
They did us awfully well, we were just saying.
It's funny, you know, Alan and I sit up there in London all week talking about education in the abstract, and sometimes it all seems very remote and theoretical. I mean, you wonder whether it's really worth making such a song and dance over. Then you come back here for an occasion like this, and suddenly you see what education is all about. Wouldn't you agree, Alan?
All we need is free brandy in the schools.
My personal feeling is that we should burn the whole lot down and start again.
You can still speak.
It's a thought, certainly.
The whole beauty of this place, you see, Bill, is it gives you the freedom to put forward ideas like that.
My personal feeling is that we ought to be free of that sort of freedom.
That's a very fair point, Bill.
Well, a very fair point, but the thing is, we can sit here and discuss whether we ought, in fact, to be sitting here or not, in a perfectly friendly way. This place is a melting pot. Different viewpoints, different classes. They sit down together over a jolly good dinner.
Jolly good wine.
Jolly good wine.
Jolly good port.
Jolly good port.
Jolly good cigars.
Jolly good cigars. And there they sit. What was that?
Melting pot.
Melting pot. It's a melting pot.
We'll all run together with our heads between our knees.
No, but you're a case in point, Dickie.
Yes, well, I am feeling slightly soft round the edges.
You're just the sort of thing I have in mind. Because when I saw you before dinner this evening, you and Alan, Alan's another example of what I'm talking about, I thought to myself, what a pair of absolute shite-hawks. I said so to David, didn't I, David?
Words to that effect.
David, I said, what a pair of absolute blue-ass titter-shites.
Titter-shites?
Something of that sort.
But now,
having sat down with you over a jolly good dinner.
Jolly good wine.
Jolly good wine.
Jolly good cigars.
Jolly good cigars. I now feel... Well, I feel it's a melting pot.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, come in, come in. Sit down. Make yourself at home.
Oh, he's not here.
Well, take him, for instance.
Chris was just saying it's a melting pot.
He walks in here. We don't know who he is.
Snell. Kenneth Snell.
I mean, we've never set eyes on him before.
I didn't have rooms in college, you see.
For all we know, he might be the man about the smell on the landing.
I'm in ethical pharmaceuticals.
And, in fact, he's in ethical pharmaceuticals, as he frankly admits. But because we've all sat down together over a jolly good dinner, we say, come in, sit down, make yourself at home.
As a matter of fact, these are my...
I'll tell you a funny thing.
Sit down, sit down.
Oh, sorry.
Well, I don't know. This may be obvious to everyone else, but it's just occurred to me as I sat here. When you look back on your life, it all seems to make some kind of sense.
I'm with you so far, David.
You can see how everything leads inevitably to everything else.
Absolutely.
But when you look forward on your life, into the future, it doesn't seem inevitable at all.
That's right, David. You've put your finger on something here.
That's certainly true of my life.
He's onto something here, isn't he?
Yes, or take my life.
And I'll tell you another funny thing.
My life has been dominated by parasitic worms.
I'll tell you another funny thing.
And parasitic worms have led me inexorably into the small intestine.
Tell us another funny thing, David.
Sorry.
Well, I don't know whether there's anything in this or not, but I was just thinking, as we all sat here, the thought simply occurred to me that, well, here we all are.
Go on.
I think that's more or less it.
Here we all are.
It does something that struck me. The thought simply came to me that, well, here we all are. Here we all absolutely are.
I think I follow.
Here I am being a medical man.
Right.
Here you are being in the government.
I see that.
There was a time when we could have been anything.
God, the things we were going to be.
I could have gone into some entirely different branch of medicine.
You mean that I could have taken the firm and my brother could have gone into the House of Commons?
But in fact, you went into the House of Commons?
Right.
And your brother runs the firm?
Absolutely.
In other words, it's become of us.
Become of us?
Well, didn't you ever wonder what would become of you?
Yes, but what has become of us?
I don't know, but whatever it is, become of us, it certainly has.
It's funny, eh? When you come to think about it.
Very funny. Very, very sad.
You know, I find this whole discussion deeply interesting. I mean, take me for instance. I'm working on parasitic infestation of the small intestine. Now, I can trace my path into the small intestine. I can follow it step by step from when I was 4 years old and I first observed regurgitation. I remember thinking when I got this job, the possibilities are endless. The whole alimentary canal lies open to me. But then I became ever more closely bound up with worms. And the worms tied me to the small intestine. Now, was there a point where I could have broken free? Was there a moment when I could have said no? No, I should go back to my first love, the esophagus. Or I shall move on and broaden my horizons by entering the large intestine. Oh, please don't misunderstand me. I'm very happy where I am. It's just that I do sometimes feel rather cramped. There are days when I look up and I think, am I going to spend the rest of my life between the duodenum and the ileum?
Are you drunk?
I don't drink.
He's drunk, eh?
No, I don't drink.
He's drunk as a fiddler.
He doesn't drink, Christopher.
There's something very odd about his manner. Comes barging in here.
We're drunk, he's sober.
Drunk who's drunk?
You're drunk.
I'm not drunk. You drunk?
I'm not drunk.
I'm not drunk, as a matter of fact.
I'm drunk.
I'm thirsty, that's what's wrong with me.
There's a barrel of beer in the buttery.
A barrel of beer in the buttery?
Oh, my word.
It's tempting.
You're a drinking man. A barrel of beer in the buttery, Bill. Is that what you'd call a temptation?
I would call that alliteration.
Who's going to come downstairs with me and commit alliteration? What are the keys, Bill?
In the porter's lodge, but please don't ask me because I'm in charge of it.
Come on, man.
The buttery bitter.
What?
Or do I mean the bitter butter?
What about us? Should we do something? Climb up somewhere? Put a chamber pot on something? Oh, this is just the kind of thing I used to miss out in lodgings.
Oh.
We're going to burgle the buttery!
Burgle the buttery?
Butter the burglary!
Watch out for Mr. Burkett!
Bugger the burglary!
Are you going to put a chamber pot on something?
I'm going to put a stop to this buttery business. After all, I am in loco parentis.
Will he be all right on the stairs?
No.
Ah, Dr. Taylor, sir. I'm off.
Off?
The overtime ban, Dr. Taylor, sir, it has begun.
Well, full support and so on, Sidney.
Thank you, Dr. Taylor, sir. I shall lock the outer gate when I leave, just in case there's any trouble.
Leave it all to me, Sidney.
I think you're the only senior member in college overnight, Dr. Taylor, sir.
I have control, Sidney. I have control.
Well, I shall be back at 7 a.m., Dr. Taylor, sir.
Have a good weekend.
Oh, if Roddy turns up, tell him we've gone to knock off one of those bottles of whiskey in the old library.
What shall I do? Put out some toilet rolls for the party.
Toilet rolls? Party? Well, it won't seem like a party unless they throw toilet rolls out of the window.
Oh, world, oh, life, oh, time, on whose last steps I climb. Trembling of that when I had stood before, when will return the glory of my prime? Tonight at 4:30.
Toilet rolls.
I'd forgotten your brown corduroy trousers. They can't be the same ones you were wearing that weekend we spent at the Ritz. Oh, Roddy, I'm sorry. I didn't plan this, of course. I didn't plan to walk in after 17 years and burst into tears. It was just seeing the trousers, half on the bed and half off, and one sock on the washstand. It was just having to wait in the bedroom while everyone was shouting in there. I didn't plan to be in the bedroom, of course. It didn't occur to me that you might bring some horde of people back here after dinner. Didn't you think I might be here? Didn't it cross your mind that I'd be waiting somewhere? Or have you just completely forgotten about me? Look, I'm not crying because of you. I didn't come to have some terrible nostalgic scene because I don't feel like that about it. I just came to see how you were and to tell you how I was, and I'm fine. I'm very happy. The sound of you jumping to wrong conclusions is deafening. That's why everyone was always so impressed by you, because you just grinned and stood there and said nothing. Oh, God, I shouldn't have come. The whole plan's gone wrong. I was going to drop by quite casually. I was going to laugh and be slightly flirtatious. Not like that. I kept dropping by.
And now I've been sitting in here for an hour and a half expecting someone to come crashing in at any moment. Thought you couldn't say anything. You must have expected to see me. You must have worked out what you were going to say. Well, say it. Say it. That beard's a mistake, by the way. It alters your whole personality. What's happened to you? You seem to have changed completely.
Snell. Kenneth Snell. Moore couldn't come. They gave me his rooms.
Have you ever had the feeling you'd like to get inside your handbag and close it firmly above your head? No, of course not. You haven't got a handbag. I think it might be best if I simply left without another word of any sort and went quietly to bed with a cup of Ovaltine. Good night.
Good night.
You're drunk, Buckle.
I'm drunk.
You're drunk as a doormat.
You're pushing the bloody barrel instead of pulling it.
You're the piss as a coot.
On second thoughts, I think I'd like to stay and talk for a moment. I'm sorry. There are some people outside on the staircase I happen to know, and I'd rather not embarrass them if I can help it. There is a certain social barrier between the drunk and the sober which is very difficult to bridge, especially on a narrow staircase.
You're the master's wife, aren't you?
Yes. Well, that comes into it, of course.
I remember you from before. I used to sometimes come into college very early in the morning to have a bath. There was no bath in my lodgings, you see.
I see.
I used to see you climbing out over that wall at the back of the bathhouse. That kind of thing wasn't possible in lodgings.
I suppose not, if there was no bath. Look, would you pop your head outside the door for me and make sure all the barrels and bodies on the stairs have stopped happening?
Well, they're coming up here, aren't they?
Yeah.
I think so.
You can't even stand up. Look at you rolling about the floor. You great tag of booze.
You shocked our bearded friend here.
No, no, it's just I thought perhaps you'd like to take it downstairs again.
What? It's taken us all this time to bring it upstairs.
Everybody's in bed. They're all trying to get to sleep. Just a moment. Someone missing. One, two, three.
Ah, there you are, Bill. That's better. That was the original Jacobean banister, you know?
Better off without it. We're doing our... What does your generation call it? We're doing our thing.
Speak for yourself, you dirty bugger.
Our bearded companion wanted to take it downstairs again.
No. Excuse me. May I introduce...
Hold on. Put it on the collapsible table.
I bet it's absolute piss now. You've shaken it all up.
Was you sod? How can you carry a barrel of beer and do your thing at the same time?
God, you've got a filthy mind, Chris. I don't know how I can bring myself to associate with you.
Excuse me, may I just introduce...
Yeah, just a moment. On the collapsible table.
It's collapsed.
This furniture costs money, you know.
I said, put it on the collapsible table.
And it collapsed.
Excuse me, I don't know whether you know.
Oh, yes, yes.
We know them all right.
They're coming along nicely. They've got to the giggling stage.
Chris said, put it on the collapsible table and it collapsed.
There's a lot of people in the world who'd be glad of a table like that.
Never mind about the table, Bill.
This isn't a holiday for some of us, you know.
In the morning, we'll all get together and make a most colossal contribution to the organ fund.
There you go again. You've got a one-track mind.
They're in form. Sing them a comic song to hear. That'll wipe the smile off their faces.
One of those old review songs that Ronnie and I used to do. Well, all right. All right. A humorous song from the shows of yesteryear. All right. I'm a naughty old nun in a nunnery. Yes, a funny old bun in a nunnery. You may think a cloister's nobody's oyster, but we have a boisterous cloister, and some of our habits are dreadfully low. Oh, it's fun being a nun. Yes, it's fun being a nun. We can't kick the habit, can none of us? Do you remember it? It was called nonetheless. What we really need is a scholar's gown.
Can't think why we're sitting here.
Listening
to this rubbish.
Let's sing our own song.
Yeah, a good, clean, dirty song.
The Odd Job Man.
The Odd Job Man.
Oh, yeah. My goodness me. I don't think we want this one floating out for all to hear.
All right. With a hey and a ho and a hey, nommy, no.
The Duchess, she called the Odd Job Man.
She said, I've some odd jobs for you. You can do them today while his grace is away. Little things he's neglected to do. Look under my skirting for mouse holes, and he's off my drawers upstairs. I could do with a screw in the outside loo and stuffing in all the armchairs. Now,
I'm a naughty old man with a history. A pastor is all wrapped in mystery. I first took the veil into the slumber, liked it so much I took hold of it.
Just give me a bang on the ceiling.
It's fun being a nun. Yes, it's fun being a nun. We can kick the habit, can some of us?
Go on, let's teabag him. Right, go on, go on.
I am a minister of religion.
Off with his trousers!
Off with his balls!
I say those are his best trousers.
Now on the grass! Fellows only on the grass!
Come on then, sit down. Shut the door.
Yes, well...
Don't shut the door.
Well, it's just that... May I introduce? I'm sorry, I don't know your name.
Oh, we're old friends. Hello, Alan. I was just passing and I remembered you said something about dropping in for a drink. How was the dinner? Was the saddle of lamb all right? What do you think of the claret?
Is this lady your guest?
Not exactly. Well,
a lady in after hours is a rather serious offence, you know.
Well, the rules don't apply to this lady, do they?
Oh!
Well, I mean, she's part of the college, isn't she?
It's all very funny to you, isn't it? You're leaving tomorrow. I've got to go on living here. I've got to go on looking Bill Taylor and Sidney Burkett in the eye.
Is that your bicycle they're riding down there?
Where? My probation reports! My court files!
Oh, dear. Please don't. Cheer up. Don't worry.
You shut up!
You go and collect up the papers. I'll look after her.
My God. Life.
Come on, none of us have found him yet.
He's not coming.
Well, perhaps he will next time.
Next time? In 20 years?
Well, it's something to look forward to.
Oh, it's their aim that terrifies me. They were trying to get my trousers off, Alan. I don't believe it. I mean, I only left you 2 minutes ago.
Good night, Dickie.
Yeah. Well, I'll see you at breakfast, perhaps. If you should need the services of a minister of religion at any time, you'll probably find me in the river.
Alan, will you please get me out of here before anyone else comes in?
Let's slip across the landing to my rooms. You'll be perfectly safe there.
Pax! Listen!
We'll toss it as a blanket.
Yeah, get a blanket
over the bed.
No. You can't go in there.
Why not?
Well, Alan's got a girl in.
Oh, gollywogs. I don't believe it. Come.
Told you.
I must say, I think it's a little unsavory.
I think it's highly unsavory.
I mean, at an occasion of this nature.
At our time of life.
It makes the rest of us look so uncommonly foolish.
Now, don't worry, there are plenty more.
More?
I'll show you.
You mean a party?
Yeah, full of nurses.
Oh! Oh,
gooseberries.
Can't get out! The college is locked up for the night owing to industrial action!
You can climb out.
Sorry. Oh, my God, I'm most terribly. Oh, dear, wait. I'll fetch. I'll be back in one. Oh, my God.
Christopher.
What?
Please, don't get up. Oh, you are up. Well, I was just passing, and I remembered you said something about dropping in for a drink. Now, I know there were several points that Harry wanted to take up with you about the future of the university grant. Christopher, what are you doing like that?
My back.
Oh, you have a back, do you?
No.
Well, I think perhaps you've got one now. You can't stay like that all night. You're going to have to be very brave and jump up straight, aren't you?
He was proposing to you.
His back.
I can see he's back in the old routine.
I must say, I never realised what living in college involved.
Great scented lollipops, he's found one already. Well done, Chris.
David, Chris has found one.
Oh, Bill, do you know the Parliamentary Undersecretary at the Department of Education?
But Rosemary, I don't understand what you're doing here. You're supposed to be downstairs in my room. We're going to go into overtime together. You're going to knock me down, walk all over me.
Thank you, Bill, for those few well-chosen words. They set the seal on a memorable evening. On that note, I think I shall leave. Thank you, Christopher. Thank you, Alan.
I'll see you back.
No, no. I'll just slip quietly away without another word and look for an all-night nunnery to enter. Good night.
Was it something I said?
Strange creatures, women, I find.
Don't you? Well, sit down, sit down. We can all have a drink. Huh? I'd be very interested to hear everyone's views on women.
Now, my glasses.
Whiskey out of a tooth glass. My God, what next?
What I can't remember is what we were doing up there in the first place.
Looking for Roddy.
What the hell is Roddy?
Well, he's not coming, after all.
You're not coming? What stood us all up?
Just like Roddy.
Oh. He doesn't know what he's missing, does he?
Packed up this sleeping bag. Up there in Alaska.
Poor old Roddy.
Never mind, we'll send him a banker's order form.
You see, my trouble is, I refuse to compromise. I demand the perfect woman. Now, am I being unrealistic? Please, please, speak frankly, because you see, what I've always missed is an opportunity like this to really talk about life.
Some fool has locked up the master's lodge. I'm terribly sorry. I'm going to have to spend the night on your sofa. Don't let me keep you up. Good night.
All right. A bit. A bit. Yes. I feel a bit. Breakfast?
Hello, David. I say, what a super morning. We really have picked the right weekend for it, you know. Sun streaming into chapel this morning. Only three of us there. Isn't that awful? You two both look in good shape, though. I feel fresh as a daisy. Then I finished up with a nice bracing dip in the river. They threw me in the river, Chris.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes, he says.
Sorry about that.
Oh, I took it all in good part.
I think we just felt it would round the evening off. Didn't we?
Did we? Oh, Chris wasn't there. This was after you'd moved on to higher things, if one might put it like that. Huh? After you'd turned your attention to more pressing concerns, so to speak.
I'm going to shave.
Oh, dear. Perhaps I shouldn't have mentioned it.
I do find it slightly reassuring, though, that one of us has still got his eye in.
Norman, what are you talking about?
I told you last night, Chris's little affair of the heart.
Oh, the popsy.
Well, I don't know about you, but I'm starving. How about a spot of breakfast?
Not just at the moment.
No? Well, see you later, then. I can smell that bacon grilling from here.
Last night, Norman thought it was staggering. In fact, we all thought it was staggering.
Oh? No, it's just a friend of mine.
A friend?
An old friend.
Oh.
Someone I hadn't seen for some time.
Oh.
Norman thought it was...
staggering.
You don't suppose Norman would,
Would what?
Didn't he say he was a writer?
Oh, I don't think he would.
You don't think he might?
Member of the same college.
Not that it matters.
Anyway, no one would print that sort of thing.
No.
Very few papers would print that sort of thing.
Can you catch him before he goes?
Explain to him.
He's just an old friend. I'm not dressed. I mean, fetch him round. I'll explain to him.
I think you politicians probably have more experience of this sort of thing.
I never sat up all night when I was an undergraduate. I never sat up talking all night like this. I wasted my time here, that's the tragedy. I wasted 3 years of my life. I never wore a fancy waistcoat. I never wrote a blasphemous poem. As for having a girl in my rooms all night, what? I'll be on the station. Don't make me laugh.
I wasn't ready for it, you see. That's the thing. I didn't know the trick. I hadn't got the knack.
I wasn't old enough to be young.
But now I could do it. Do you see? Because here I am, doing it. Do you see that? I am making sense, aren't I? I mean, here I am. Rooms in college. Girl in all night. Wait. Wait here. I want a mature studentship. Huh? I want a mature studentship. A mature studentship, as I understand it, is intended for applicants of mature years who missed their educational opportunities when they were younger.
Dinner jacket.
Now, I missed my educational opportunities when I was younger. I see that now. I want to come into residence this October. I don't want to waste any more time.
Yeah, you'll have to talk to the college about that.
Oh, I'm ready to take the college entrance examination again if they want me to.
Yes, it was nothing to do with me. It's not the Department of Education.
But this is a concession. Yeah.
Dr. Taylor.
I have a right to a room in college.
Get the forms from Dr. Taylor.
I had a right to a room in college in my third year, and yes. I was cheated out of it.
Dr. Taylor.
Bill Taylor.
Door opposite.
He'd be the man to talk to,
would he? Oh, yes, he would.
I have already taken this up with the Department of Education, I may say, and at the highest level. So, my immediate plans are to go to the buttery, buy a tin of coffee and a jar of Cooper's Oxford Marmalade. Then, I'm going to run down to the corner and buy the Sunday papers. We can sit on the floor all morning, having breakfast. Papers spread out all around us. I know how it's done, you see. I know the things you do all right, and now I can do them. It's as simple as that.
Newspaper.
A newspaper?
A newspaper.
A newspaper? Where?
Where?
Here?
What?
Which newspaper?
Which newspaper? I don't mind which newspaper, any newspaper.
Just a moment. Let me get this clear. Is there or is there not a newspaper snooping around here?
I can't understand what you're talking about. I simply want a newspaper.
You want a newspaper?
I want a newspaper.
Rosemary, what do you want a newspaper for?
What do I want a newspaper for? I want a newspaper to read.
To read?
Oh, my God.
Has something happened? Not the government.
I want a newspaper to read while I am walking back to the master's lodge so that it's in front of my face. I can't walk through the college in broad daylight with this face sticking out of Alan Quine's suit. You can't run a college like that.
Yes, but Rosemary, why?
Why? Because that lunatic with a beard is having a breakdown. He's been walking up and down all night talking to himself.
Yes, but
Christopher, just give me a newspaper.
Rosemary.
I am living through a nightmare. I think I have a right to expect my friends to help.
I haven't got a newspaper.
All that, and he hasn't got a newspaper.
Bill Taylor.
A junior minister, and he hasn't got a newspaper.
Try Bill Taylor.
How you became a politician, Christopher, I shall never know.
No, not staggering at all. Just an old friend. Chris will explain better than me.
Two men.
Chris, it's us.
Stem, here.
Where?
Bedroom.
No.
You must.
You're
coming! Come on!
Didn't say
come
in.
No!
Dear, perhaps we should...
No!
Newspapers.
Got them?
It's them.
Oh.
Not just my career.
No, my career.
The whole government's last straw.
Good riddance.
No, the pound.
Oh, the pound.
We were starting to wonder what you were up to.
Up to? Nothing.
Oh, I can see you were shaving.
No. Oh, yes, I was shaving.
Carry on, then.
No, it's nice to down tools for a moment.
Well, we only looked in for a chat, didn't we, Norman?
Well, sit down. So you just looked in for a chat, did you?
Where's the razor in here?
Sit down! If we're gonna chat, let's chat!
Oh, sorry.
Well, the thing is this. Norman and I were just nattering away over breakfast about the events of last night.
Ah. Now, oh, very nice of you to drop in. If only all newspapers took the trouble to check their information in this very sensible manner, then they wouldn't be faced with cripplingly expensive libel actions.
Chris, sorry, I can't bear to see you sitting there with lather all over your face. I'll fetch a towel.
No, have a towel. Here.
It was you, wasn't it? All part of the fun and game.
What is everyone on about this morning?
I thought we were all the japes and wheezes over last night.
People come in screaming they want mature students.
Where is it?
Where is what?
My suit.
Your suit?
I thought so. In there.
Stay away from that.
I'm not going to be pushed about by some piss-pot junior man.
And I'm not going to have some dedicated civil servant snooping around my bedroom.
Dirty little skin off
me. Dolloping donuts.
Come on,
take it easy, Chris. We're not up to this sort of thing this morning. Someone's going to get hurt.
Stop. David's got a hurt eye.
Look, we'll soon settle this. I'll look.
Bill Taylor.
Bill Taylor's got the suit.
Bill Taylor.
After him, restrain him.
Where do you think you're going?
A cold flannel for David's eye.
Bill Taylor. Bill Taylor's got a cold flannel. Suit! Cold flannel!
Suit! What do you mean, suit? Suit!
Take it off!
What do you think, this is a strip club?
Where is she? I left her behind locked doors. In my rooms. Rooms that are mine by rights.
Phil Taylor.
She's in here, isn't she? Things have changed, you know. You lot only go on wiping your boots on me.
Bill Taylor.
Taylor. Did you know I can break a plank in half with the edge of my hand?
Run!
Run!
man with beard!
Where?
Here!
Gone?
Coming back!
He's mad!
Run!
Cheat!
Oh, God!
You said...
I didn't say cheat!
You said suit!
I said run!
Quine!
Get it, damn it! Shoot!
You want the suit?
Shoot! 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 Shoot!
Where's my suit? We ransacked Bill's rooms.
Man with beard!
Bill was a bit cross about it.
Beard, beard, beard!
Beard?
Do it upstairs.
Back.
I haven't got your suit!
I don't want my suit! I want my fiancé!
Up here is beard!
Not
suit!
Suit!
Man with beard.
Man with a beard.
Not there.
No, in your room.
In my room?
Miss Quine.
Quine?
Left his suit.
Took his suit off.
And then rush upstairs.
I'll kill him.
He's hiding somewhere. I'll take his beard to his bones. I'll kick his kneecaps in. Go, oh, beard.
Beard?
Beard.
Beard. Beard. Beard.
I am safe.
My little Rosemary. In Bill Taylor's rooms. Quine is.
Bill Taylor's rooms?
Suit.
Suit.
Where he left it. Tell him.
Right.
Where is my suit?
There must be.
Alan. That's right. No. All this, a treasure hunt. People screaming, they want suits, they want women, they want beards, they want mature studentships. There's one complete bloody lunatic still wearing a dinner jacket. What do you want?
Watch out for that one.
He's back.
He woke me up this morning to tell me he wants a mature studentship.
Yeah. Give him one.
Give him one?
If that's what he wants.
I can't just hand out mature studentships, what, on Sunday morning in my pajamas?
Well, get him out of here, he's berserk. He was berserk.
He's gone quiet.
I don't like the way he's reading that paper.
That man with the beard suddenly rushed
in his dinner jacket,
and kicked Alan on the kneecap.
He's gone mad.
He's plainly in the middle of a gross psychotic breakdown. Right. Leave this to me.
Thank heavens we've got a doctor here.
You'll need a doctor when I finish with him.
Calm down, Alan. There's nothing to get worked up about. Norman, will you run and have a word with Mr. Birkett? Ask him to ring for an ambulance. Come along, then, old chap. Let's have a look at you.
Careful, he may suddenly flare up again.
Leave this to me, will you, Bill?
Keep away from his feet.
You know he can break a plank in half with the edge of his hand.
Do you mind? Right. Let's put the newspaper down, shall we?
Ah! Oh!
No! Run, run, run!
Oh. Oh. Now, go!
If I'd have known everyone was going to get on this morning, start running around with paper bags over their heads. I could put my head inside a paper bag.
Going up. Roof of the chapel. Not going to throw himself off.
You haven't seen a clerical collar lying around anywhere, have you, Norman? Size 7. I can't go into chapel like this.
Dickie, eh? Speak to him.
Yes. You're a clergyman.
Go on, Dickie. It's the man with the beard.
I wish I had my collar. You haven't seen it anywhere, have you?
He'll be off there before you've got started.
Excuse me. Oh, this is hopeless.
Louder.
Look, honestly, I don't feel up to this sort of work this morning. I... Hello there. Look, what's his name?
We don't know, do we?
This is hopeless. Like making bricks without straw. You... We all of us feel, from time to time, that life isn't worth living. Is that right? Is that the sort of thing one says? I feel pretty terrible myself this morning.
He's gone round the other side.
It's no good without the collar.
He must have slid down the lightning conductor.
I did it. Well, I did it.
Now, no! She's not in Buckle's room, and she's not in Tate's room. So she must be in there.
No! Sydney! Come down. Down here, now.
Right, then. Let's dress him up for a while I get the Valium out of the car.
Off you go, then.
In here.
Right, in the bedroom.
No, not in there!
What is it?
Out, out, out!
They're both mad.
Chris! Chris!
Listen! Listen! I must go in! Take your hands off me! Everyone leave this room! That is an order! That is a directive issued by a minister of the crown!
Chris, what are you on about?
Come on, Chris!
Listen! He's killed her!
Killed her?
Killed her?
Yes. There was a lady in there. I knew it all the time.
Open the door.
Open the door, Helen.
Where is she? Yes, he's killed her.
He's killed her?
Killed her!
Killed her!
Call the police.
The police, call the police.
I'm going to go out and buy a brocade waistcoat.
How much did you give him?
50 milligrams.
I'll keep a tiger cub in my rooms.
He couldn't have hidden her under the floorboards, could he?
I'll wear a sword. I'll fight duels.
This will, of course, destroy my career. May also destroy the government. May even destroy the pound.
Oh, the police are here. And did one of you call an ambulance? Apparently it's waiting to take someone to a mental hospital.
We can get married in the college chapel.
Mr. Headingley, sir, the police. This is him, Mr. Headingley. He'll tell you.
What's the matter?
He's not going to be sick, is he?
We have a tradition in the House of Commons. A member may rise and make a personal statement. He may say, in all sincerity and in all humility, I've made a mistake. I feel that tradition is a fine and valuable one. Today, I stand not before the House, but before my friends. And I say to you, as I would to the House, in all sincerity and in all humility, I've made a mistake.
Well, we all make mistakes.
Bye, Mr. Sainsbury, sir. Bye, Mr. Tate, sir.
Bye, Mr. Burkett. Jolly super party. Thank you for having us.
See you again in 20 years' time.
My word, yes, it'll be almost the end of the century.
Yes. and see us again, Mr. Snell. We won't forget you next time.
I'll notify everyone about the wedding.